Good morning, friends. In this session, we are going to discuss the power transmitted by the belt drive. Right, so this belt drive is a power transmission drive. Right, the power is transmitted when the belt runs over the pulleys. That means first the motion transmission must take place. Thereby the power transmission takes place between the shafts, right? So to get the power transmission using this belt drive, the belt is wrapped over the mountings on the shafts called pulleys, right? The pulleys are mounted on the shafts and the belt is wrapped around this pulleys. Power transmitted by belt drive, capital P. Right, so the belt is wrapped around the pulleys. The ends of the belt are joined together with the help of suitable joint, and the frictional grip between the inner surface of the belt and the outer surface of the pulley is the cause of motion. Thereby the driven pulley is carried by the belt, right? Thereby the shaft on which the driven pulley is mounted is also subjected to the rotation. That's how the power transmission takes place from driving pulley to driven pulley. Okay, so the driving pulley pulls the belt from the driven pulley and it delivers to the other side. So that means every belt drive consists of two sides, right? So here these sides are simply known as the tight side and slack side based on the magnitude of its tension. Right, generally the tight side is at the bottom of the belt drive. Bottom side is the tight side and top side is the slack side. Okay, this is a tight side. So in this tight side the belt is pulled by the driving pulley. Let us take this larger of the two pulleys is the driving pulley and smaller of the two pulleys is the driven pulley. Let us take one suffix one refers driving pulley and suffix two refers driven pulley. O1 and O2 are the centers of driving and driven pulleys, right? Let us assume that the driving pulley rotates in clockwise direction. Since it is an open belt drive, the driven pulley also rotates in the same direction, right? Okay. Then the driving pulley pulls the belt on one side and that side is called tight side and it delivers to the other side, right? Obviously the tension on this side is slightly less compared to the former side. That's why this is called a slack side. Okay, then generally the tension on tight side is designated with the T1 and tension on slack side is designated with the T2 in our earlier discussions. So that's why I'm taking same type of notations here, right? Let us take T1 is the tension on tight side, T2 is tension on slack side. So this is a pulling side and this is delivery side. Okay. Now, when you indicate the tensions on both the pulleys, right? So, if you consider driving pulley, it is subjected to tension T1 here and it delivers the belt to the other side and the tension on this side is T2. Tension on this side is T2. then what is the net effect force, effective force acting on this pulley? That is, this side the force is T1 and this side the force is T2. What is the net effective force? Net effective force on this pulley is T1 minus T2. So this side it is subjected to T1 here, and this side it is subjected to T2 here. Then T1 is greater than T2. T1 is greater than T2. Since the tension on tight side is always greater than tension on slack side, T1 is greater than T2. What is the net effective force? T1 minus T2 is the net effective force acting on the pulley. Okay, and this is the force which causes its motion, which causes its the power transmission. Okay, so that means this net effective force is subjected to certain amount of displacement, so that the work is done by the belt. What is the work done by the belt? Work done by the belt is equal to force into displacement. What is the displacement of the belt here? Let us assume V is the velocity of the belt. Velocity of the belt. What do you mean by velocity? Velocity is nothing but displacement per unit time, or rate of change of displacement is called velocity, right? So the displacement of this driving pulley or the belt is represented in terms of meters per second. That is V meters per second. Then the force into displacement. Force into displacement is nothing but work done. Force into displacement is nothing but work done. What is the force here? T1 minus T2 is the force in the driving pulley. Into displacement is V meters per second. V meters per second. Then T1 minus T2 into V is the work done by the belt. Work done by the belt. Okay. So this work done, force is T1 minus T2, which is in terms of newtons. V is meters per second, newton meter per second. It is simply joule per second. Joule per second is nothing but watts. So that is nothing but power transmitted by the belt drive. Power transmitted by the belt drive. So T1 minus T2 into V is the power transmitted by the belt drive. Right? I hope it is clear. Now, let T1 and T2 are the tensions on tight and slack sides respectively. Then work done by the belt drive. Work done by the belt drive W is equal to T1 minus T2 into V meters per second, where V is the velocity of the belt, right? So this is in terms of newtons per newtons, right? So that the work done is newton meter per second. Therefore, power transmitted. Is equal to work done by the belt. Right? That is equal to capital P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V, units are newton meter per second. Newton meter per second. So that is equal to T1 minus T2 into V watts. So this is power transmitted by the belt drive. Okay. Is it clear? Simple equation, right? So what is the condition for the maximum power transfer? right? So this is the condition for this is the power transmission equation. Now if you substitute v, what is the v here? Linear velocity of the belt. If we consider angular velocity, that's equal to t1 minus t2 into what is v here? V is 2 pi m by 60 is angular velocity r omega, 2 pi m by 60 into radius of the pulley, r. Then you will get t1 minus t2, 2 pi n t1 minus t2 into r divided by 60. What is 2r? 2r is the diameter of the pulley. Okay, so like this you can write pi dn t1 minus t2 by 60, or 2 pi nt by 60. What is t1 minus t2 into r? That is nothing but torque transmitted by the pulley. So you can express 2 pi n into t by 60. This is your regular power transmission equation. What is t here? T is nothing but torque transmitted. It is not maximum tension. Torque transmitted by the belt. Right? Torque transmitted, T is equal to T1 minus T2. T1 minus T2 into radius. T1 minus T2 into radius is the torque transmitted. So simply, power transmitted P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60. That is your standard equation. Is it okay? Now we'll see the condition for maximum power transfer. So power transfer by the belt drive, P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V. T1 minus T2 into V. But T2 is equal to from ratio of driving tensions. But T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. This is we have already considered. From this, T2 is equal to T1 by e power mu theta. Now you just substitute this in the power transmission equation. Implies P is equal to T1 minus T1 by e power mu theta into V. Now you bring T1 as common factor. T1 into 1 minus 1 by e power mu theta into V. Okay. Now we take this as some constant. Let us take C here. Then you can rewrite this power transmission equation as P is equal to T1 into C into V. Where C is equal to 1 minus 1 by e power mu theta. Okay. But T1 is equal to maximum tension in the belt minus centrifugal tension. Right? Now you just rewrite this equation. P is equal to, instead of T1, you just substitute T minus TC into C into V. Now you can simplify this. What is TC here? T minus centrifugal tension is mv square. This we already derived, into V into
C. That is equal to P into V minus MV cube into some constant C. Now this is power transmitted equation in terms of variable. What is the variable here? Variable is the velocity. Now you consider maximum minimum principle. For maximum power transfer, differentiate this P with respect to V and equate it to zero. Right? For maximum power transfer, differentiate power equation dP by dV is equal to zero. Implies, right? Derivative of TV, right? Derivative of V is 1, T minus derivative of V cube, M is constant. So anyway, this is constant, no need to consider this. M into, what is the derivative of V cube? 3V square is equal to 0. Implies T is equal to 3 into MV square. What is MV square? MV square is centrifugal tension. So T is equal to 3 into TC. That means it shows that the power transmitted is maximum, right? If the centrifugal tension is 1/3 of the maximum tension, right? So that means from this you can write TC is equal to T by 3, right? If the centrifugal tension is 1/3 of the maximum tension, then the power transmitted is maximum. So from this you can find out the limiting velocity or the velocity of the belt for the maximum transfer. From this you can rewrite the velocity equation. V is equal to T by 3m under root. Right? So this is the velocity of the belt for maximum power transfer. So velocity of belt. For P maximum. Okay. So this M is mass of the belt per unit length. M is the mass of the belt per unit length. If you want to replace mass with the weight, you will get double E by G instead of M here. That's how the power transmitted by the belt drive is analyzed, right? First, you need to find out the power transmission equation. P is equal to 2 pi NT by 60. And T here, torque transmitted by the belt, that is equal to difference of its driving tensions into radius of the pulley. Okay, once you have the power transmitted equation, you can bring this to the variable form. And if you differentiate this with respect to variable and equate it to zero, this is maximum minimum principle, dP by dV is equal to zero. From this, you will get the condition for maximum power transfer. When the centrifugal tension, the belt is 1/3 of the maximum tension, then the power transmitted is maximum. And corresponding velocity, the belt velocity, when the belt is transmitting maximum power, V is equal to under root of T by 3M. So this is the power transmitted by the belt drive. Right? Is it clear, all of you? I hope you understood. Right? Thank you.